Hi everybody, Vermont Survivalist here. Another fun-filled video. Oh yeah. So this video is on the 1911. I mean, I swear to God, if you want to make a controversial video, all you need to do is put a video that shits on the 1911. Because everybody tries to make these bullshit points why the 1911 sucks. Oh yeah, and that bullshit too. You notice everybody's points on the 1911, they're really not points at all. They're just like, I don't know what the fuck they are. I watched instructors instruct that the 1911 sucks, which is bullshit. I saw Marine infantry guys, devil dogs, sitting there talking, well, the 1911 is not a very good self-defense weapon. Everybody's taking a shot at it. You know what I mean? And it's usually the same talking points over and over and over and over again. What happens is that people get a lot of views on it, likes and dislikes. That's what it's all about. That's all what it's about. I'm trying to be all controversial. The first ass clown, we already know who that was. Talk about the 1911. Is the 1911 overpriced? Fuck yeah, every gun's overpriced. In my opinion, anyways. Right? But is the 1911 a piece of shit? No. No. It will never be. You know what I mean? It's one of those handguns that stuck around for a reason. It's like the Browning 50. The Mod Dukes, motherfucker. It's like one of those, okay? It works. And it's fucking awesome. So what is the 1911? 1911 to me is a handgun work of fucking art. John Browning's finest right there. Was it Browning? Was it Colt? I think it was Colt. Maybe I ought to get my weapons facts straight before I start fucking talking shit. So, anyways, why don't we just kinda, don't matter if it's Colt, doesn't matter if it's Browning. Who gives a fuck? They're both weapons geniuses in themselves. So, why don't we just go through this fucking 1911 bullshit? Come a tear down everybody's arguments on why the 1911 sucks. You want to hear why? Because I want to. So, without further ado, all the mechanics. Oh my God, all the parts have to fit perfectly. You know, if the 1911 isn't made right, it's just not going to work. It's just not going to work. I mean, most people, you know. No shit. It's a mechanical fucking device. What do you think? It tends to happen when you have moving parts, you know? If they don't fit right, or if they don't, you know, fit right. If they don't, you know, fit right. Well, guess what? It's not going to work right. Oh, it took a fucking genius to figure that out. Like, what the fuck? Like, seriously. How long did it take that motherfucker to figure that out? I'm the best fucking gun guy in all of YouTube. Kiss my ass. How many bowls of cereal did it take for you to figure that out? Hmm? Oh my fucking God, dude. Fucking next. The magazine count is just too low. What are you, fucking John Wick? So you mean to tell me, everybody, most of the people that I've seen, they have their instructors and all that stuff, right? So you mean to tell me you can't make 7 rounds work? Hmm? So that means if you were given 7 rounds, you mean to tell me you can't make that shit work? Hmm? 7 rounds is just too low for your liking, huh? Give me a fucking break. You can at least get 2 or 3 guys with that, right? I'm assuming. I'm thinking. Quite possibly. I mean what are you doing? What are you, just kicking out the door and just spraying all over the place? Like back in high school. I mean, for real. For real. And plus, you hear it all the time on the internet. Well, I don't know why they put a magazine ban. It doesn't matter because you can change out the mag just fast. So what's the problem? I mean, you got 7 rounds, but if you got a pocket full of other mags, you can change it out real fast. So what's the issue? Right? Oh, the stress, right? The stress. The stress, when people are under stress, you know what I mean? It breaks them down, tears them apart, rips them in two. You know what I mean? You start fumbling all over yourself. Next thing you know, you're taking a magazine, you're putting it in backwards. But you're a trainer. Next! This part right here. It's like an oxymoron to me. Okay? Every fucking YouTube channel bitches about safety. Bitches about it.
Oh, safety this, safety that. Oh, get a holster. You don't want a felony carry. Manipulate your safety.
Now, for the first fucking time ever, the safety's all of a sudden the fucking problem. It doesn't insult you with a safety. I think a Glock guy said that. You know what I mean? 1911 thumb safety. You know, when you're in a stressful situation, you can't manipulate the safety. Look, if you can't manipulate the fucking safety, my suggestion to you is, well, get gun training. And the backstrap. For some reason, nobody can hit the backstrap. You know, under stressful situations, that backstrap's just going to be so hard to fucking, you know, hit. You won't be able to do it because your gun's going to be sitting lower. You know what I mean? So if your sidearm's sitting lower, and because you're under so much stress. Look, there's a thing called muscle fucking memory. Okay, let's say it together. Ready? Muscle memory. Yeah, okay. Well, that really comes into play when, I don't know, somebody's shooting at you. You're no longer thinking about that. You shouldn't have to think about it. You should just react. I mean, that's what I was told. And if you have a problem manipulating the goddamn thumb safety, then I hope you don't own an AR-15, because guess what you're doing? You're fucking manipulating the fucking thumb safety. Oh, no! What the fuck, dude? So everybody's arguments against the 1911, fucking bullshit. Unfucking believable. Look, I can think of plenty of shit wrong with the fucking Glock, but doesn't negate the fact that the Glock is a reliable platform. Even though I don't like it, but it doesn't negate the fact that Glock is a reliable platform. And for somebody that doesn't, that whoever doesn't own a Glock, it's pretty fucking stupid considering the fact that everybody owns a Glock. And I can think of plenty of shit wrong with a Glock. Out of the box, a Glock sucks. Out of the fucking box, okay? The trigger sucks. The forward sight and the rear sight aperture sucks. It looks uglier than fucking sin. It's about as ugly as me. This whole fucking thing of the 1911 and why it sucks is so full of shit, like I said before. Oh my fucking God. 1911 is a great handgun. Really fucking great handgun. And you know what? The 1911 has lasted, well, since 1911. That just tells you how good that fucking handgun is. And it will last the test of time. And I have a funny feeling 1911, it's going to be around for a very, very, very long time. Because combat units still use it to this day. It's just reliable. It's a reliable piece of kit. And like everything else, it's all on how you treat it. If you treat your fucking weapons platform like shit, then guess what? It's going to fail you. I don't care what platform you have. It's going to fucking fail you. The round count, you know, the way I see it, when somebody carries a 1911 with 7 rounds in it, well, we'll just go 8 rounds. You got one in the pipe, of course. All you technical motherfuckers out there. Okay. To me, it just shows confidence. That you are confident in your skill to hit whoever is trying to harm you. That's it. You know? And I'm not shitting on anybody that carries 20 fucking 9mm rounds. I have no problem with 9mm. You know what I mean? But what I do have a problem is you get all these fucking defensive guys, these instructors, that are sitting there telling you what you can and cannot carry. Okay? When their whole fucking job is just to be teachers and teach you how to use your shit. To an instructor, to somebody in that class of firearms, they should know damn well it doesn't matter what the fuck you carry. Your job is to teach somebody how to fucking use it. Like, the biggest fucking thing I see is, I've seen it all the time in class. I've seen all, the, you know, it don't matter what you see in class. That's not what I'm paying you to fucking do. What I'm paying you to do is I'm paying you to teach me on a platform that I'm used to. You know what I mean? I'm not paying you to instruct me on what I need to carry. What are you, my fucking fairy godmother? I'm paying you to teach me to win. Well, I'm not paying them, but the person, you know what I mean? And maybe 1911, that's what they're used to. You know what I mean? Maybe a revolver, that's what they're used to. Teach them how to use that shit. You know what I mean? And then along the way, if you want to introduce them to fucking flock, then go right ahead. You know what I mean? But teach them how to win with the platform that they got. Because maybe that's what they're used to. Maybe that's what they're familiar with. And that's the best way, that's the best way to win a fight, if you're on familiar territory. You know what I mean? You throw some, you throw, you know, an AK in front of somebody that's all he ever fired was an AR-15, then guess what? You know, you're going to get a different result. That's just how it works. You know what I mean? And I'm not even an instructor and I'm saying that. I don't know. It just, it's common sense gun control to me. So Vermont Survivalists, as always, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Fucking A. I have to defend the 1911 because I absolutely love the 1911. I think it's a great platform. And it's a good platform for somebody to learn on. Obviously, you're not going to put it in somebody's hands that never shot a gun in their lives. I think that's a fucking dick move when somebody does that. You know, they get the largest gun, they put it in the guy's hand, never fired, and they all get giggles. Look at all. It's a fucking dick move, you know. I definitely disagree with that. You know, start off with a 9mm, shit like that. Get yourself familiar with a 380 9mm. Fuck it. You might as well start with a 22. Learn the fundamentals and work your way up, right? And I'm not an instructor. Was it Reese? Valor Ridge, the guy from Valor Ridge. I have mad respect for him. On one of the videos that he did, he sat there and said, you know what? You carry the biggest, largest caliber that you can carry and rock it. And, you know, I respect that. I do respect that to the fullest. Your defense is your problem. You know what I mean? It's a matter of opinion, and opinions are like assholes. Everybody's got one, including this video. So here we go. Vermont Survivalists on the 1911.